Hi, these are the 15 new watercolors from Shmeika featuring granulating pigment mixtures that easily create texture and sometimes color separation. These effects are notable in very wet washes where the water helps disperse the lighter pigment particles away from the heavier clumping pigments. As can be expected for large particle granulating colors, these are colors that easily lift and do not heavily stain the paper. This means they are easy to erase for highlights or correcting mistakes, but also that they are not ideal for layering. You will get the best effect by doing one very wet wash that you leave alone to dry. The texture effect will be most notable if you do not overwork it. Most of these colors are semi-opaque with 2 to 3 pigment ingredients. I'll be showing how to easily mix these colors for yourself using the base ingredients in a moment. The deep sea blue was the only one that didn't seem appropriately labeled as the very opaque color that it is. Though it's not surprising that these tend to be opaque, considering 8 of the colors contain a cobalt pigment, 5 of which are PG50, cobalt turquoise, sometimes called teal in other brands. There is the most color separation in 5 colors called galaxy brown, glacier brown, galaxy violet, glacier green, and deep sea indigo. Otherwise, there are some redundant blues that are similar enough that I would say that no one really needs to collect each and every one. I was particularly disappointed with deep sea blue, glacier turquoise, and galaxy blue, which seemed to ruin their beautiful teal base pigment by creating a dull mixture with no notable color separation. I had hoped that maybe they did something special, like use a hard to replicate ratio or a pigment that was not ground as finely as their other paint to promote a stronger granulation texture. A little like how it's not always easy to get an exact duplicate when you try to mix a color separating Daniel Smith paint. This is not the case here, and these are pretty straightforward mixes you can easily replicate if you have some of the single pigment paints. For anyone not familiar with pigment numbers, professional watercolors have the pigment code on the tube, which tells you the ingredient of the paint. For each color, I'll write down the ingredients that went into it so you could mix your own using those colors. I feel like the most vital colors you may want from this particular brand is their cobalt turquoise, Potter's pink, Viridian, cobalt violet hue, and mahogany brown. I didn't have the right PB29 or PBR6, but similar mixes can be made by swapping those out for any ultramarine you might already have, and any earth brown like burnt siennas or umbers. I suspect that they use Shmeika's French ultramarine in the colors noted as having PB29, notably the most granulating of their 3 versions of ultramarine that they offer. In the long run, if you're dedicated to watercolor painting, it will definitely benefit you to have a selection of single pigments instead of convenience mixtures, though I certainly don't shy away from mixtures that I believe I will use often. Unfortunately, I found that this color selection as a whole was a bit tricky to work with as far as deciding subject matter to paint, so I went with their suggested names of deep sea and glacier for a quick watercolor sketchbook piece. I wasn't happy with it, so I tried again based on the galaxy colors. While I enjoyed working with the Galaxy colors, they were so granulating that I'm not sure how well this works for space or night sky. It sure does have a pretty texture, though. And then it hit me that I really should just focus on a couple of my favorite colors that really inspire me. My favorites are definitely the Glacier Green and Galaxy Brown. The green and pink separation of Potter's Pink and Cobalt Turquoise is just such a beautiful mixture. The Galaxy Brown combines cobalt violet hue with a warm earth brown, possibly their color called Mars Brown, though it's got a reddish hint that reminds me of their maroon brown. I can see painting furry or feathered animals with this brown, perfect for testing out on this little bird. I'll put links to the art supplies I used in this video in the description below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on these convenience mixtures. Could you see yourself using any of these pre-made mixes, or would you prefer to do it yourself with a palette of single pigments? I can definitely value learning some new combinations, but I didn't need to buy all of these colors. I just get a little impulsive when I see new granulating or color separating paints, which is the thing I love most about watercolor painting. If you'd like to see more, you can find all of my detailed swatch card images, results from my independent light fast testing, and other art supply reviews on my website. I'm currently building a huge pigment database where thousands of colors can be compared side by side with paint from other brands. Updates about this project, along with line art drawings and high-res color scans, are also available on Patreon. Thanks for watching.